touching on the back. What you see is good intentions. It's for clout and hitters, man. You can never be a subject carry. Gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you. Papa's trying to change you. I built my own foundation. And now we get a peek at some of the top players here for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis ready to go in the booth. We hope you're ready to go at the controls. Let's play. Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. And off we go from MetLife Stadium. From his end zone, Wilson. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. To throw is Namath. Eluding the pressure right. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked up by Marco Wilson. And they'll spot him at the 3-yard line. Well, we knew this game had the potential to have quite a few twists and turns, but maybe not on the very first play of the game.
And not only did they end up with an interception, they got an actual bonus, too. A nice return ends up setting them up first and goal. What a change and what a twist.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, I know defensive coordinator is going to be pretty excited by what he just saw there. Great knockback by their front. And now with the ball where it is, I would expect to see the offense throw the ball on second and third down here.
On second and goal, Jackson, it's complete. Touchdown, Jets. Elijah Moore from 4 yards out. And the Jets on just two plays have taken the lead. So now the Jets are lining up to go for two. Punt gonna run for it. And he is not gonna make it. They stop him up short, and this will remain a 6-0 ball game. So they went for two and failed. They didn't use him on the PAT, but now he boots this one away with a 6-0 lead. From his end zone, Wilson. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. Not the start that they were hoping for. The interception on the first play of the game, it leads to 6 points the other way. How do you rebound from here?
A little bit of humor. Got to laugh that one off, and not the ha-ha. That was very funny, but kind of like, can you believe that just happened? Let's go out and play now. Let's just start over.
Second and five. Off the play fake, it's Namath. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Now Namath. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds.
I'm not sure that that was necessarily a safety valve or a check down throw on third down. Sometimes just try and find the open guy and get him the ball. He did exactly that and found a way to pick up a first down.
Now a throw here to his running back. Yeah, this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Not only did we just see back-to-back nice gains, but we're also seeing the confidence rise, not just for the guy who caught it, but the guy throwing it as well.
And these back-to-back catches here out of the backfield, that can set something up downfield in a later sequence, right?
A lot of the time, it starts...
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by John Johnson. And the Jets are going to have the football here at their own 35-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, You would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at him. Instead, they read their keys well, and they took the shot downfield. They were more than prepared for that one.
That is definitely what we call on defense an uh-oh play. And what you mean by that is against Lamar Jackson. When you see him out of the pocket, your first thought is, uh-oh, he's going to try and run it. How do I get to him and get him on the ground? And guess what? That didn't happen, and his receivers took advantage.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
They will get 4 yards here on the first down run, and that'll make it 2nd and 6.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Now, meanwhile, here's a 2nd down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. They got to get to the 23 here on 3rd. Jackson. Escaping the pressure right. And that's going to be another 1st down as the tackle made at the Jets' 13-yard line. From the 13 now, they work on 1st and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's 2nd down. They'll run with a longtime Buccaneer. It's Mike Alstott. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. After a gain of 5, they'll wind up being about a length of the football short here on 3rd down. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. 6-0 our score after 1. Jackson will keep it, and he is in. Touchdown, New York.